So let us start. Here we will be studying about surface integrals in terms of vector quantities. So let me define what is a surface integral. Suppose we are given this coordinate system x, y and z. So this is our coordinate system having this as the x-axis, this as the y-axis, and this is the z-axis. This is the corresponding origin. Here, if we assume this to be some surface, right? So this is a surface S. So corresponding to this surface, when you take the projection of this surface, when you take the projection of this surface onto the corresponding xy plane, so in that case, you will obtain a surface similar to this one, right? So this is the projection of the surface onto this xy plane. And in this surface, if I am assuming this small portion, so I am calling this small portion as ds. So this ds is the magnitude of the small surface that I am considering. If now the surface S has two sides, one side we call to be positive side and another side we call that to be negative side. Usually the positive side we consider the positive side to be the one which is taken as outside portion of the surface. So suppose the surface is a closed surface. For example, I am talking about the circle or some closed surface like this surface of a sphere. So in that case, this is the 3D figure, right? In that case, this sphere, the outer surface would act as positive side and the inner surface of this sphere would act as negative side. So according to this thing, we can define the direction of the surface by the unit vector n cap, which we define to be the vector. Now what is n cap? N cap is a vector quantity, a unit vector, which is perpendicular to the given surface, which is perpendicular to the given surface. So this is defined as the unit vector. So in that case, suppose I wanted to represent this small portion of surface as a surface vector. So I can write this to be ds vector. Now this would be equal to the direction here is going to be this n cap vector, because I have defined this to be in this way. And moreover, the magnitude here is represented by this ds. So vector ds, that would be equal to ds into the unit vector n cap. So this is how you define the small surface. Now in order to define the double integral here, so your double integral, what would be that? The double integral is defined by taking the double integration over the given surface, whatever surface is given to you, of some vector quantity f dot with the small vector surface, so ds vector, right? And this you can write, because your ds vector, that is equal to ds into n cap, so you can write this vector as the double integration over s of the vector f dot with, now what is this, instead of this we can write n vector, n unit vector into ds. So this is your surface integral of the vector f over the surface S. So that means you are taking the small portion of the surface and you are integrating over the whole surface. And sometimes we denote this by, sometimes we denote the surface integral by this quantity, double integral where you put a round sign over onto it. So it means we are talking about the closed surface. So whenever you have some closed surface, you can also write your surface integral in this particular form of the vector f dot with the vector ds, right? So this is the notation. Okay, so now let us discuss how can we calculate this surface integrals. So one way to calculate these surface integrals is to take the projection of the given surface. So what we do, so the question here is, how can we compute the surface integrals? So one way to do that is, the answer is, we can convert the corresponding surface integrals to the double integrals. And we already know how can we solve these double integrals. So how can you change the surface integrals to the double integrals? So what we can do, we can take the orthogonal projection of the surface S onto the coordinate planes. Now what are the coordinate planes? Just as you have the coordinate axis, so suppose let me draw the coordinate axis. So this is origin, this is x axis, y axis and z axis, right? So this is your yz plane, this is your xy plane, and this is your xz plane. So these three planes, they are known as the coordinate planes, right? So we can take the projection of whatever is the surface given to you. So suppose this is the surface that is given to you. So you could take the projection of the surface onto here, and then you could calculate the double integral of this surface. So you can calculate the region here according to this projection, the double integral in the 2D plane according to the given figure. So accordingly, how can we do that? Suppose S is the corresponding surface with respect to which we are to calculate the surface integral. So what we do? We construct a line which is perpendicular to this surface. So suppose your line is this one, right? So corresponding to this line, the unit vector which is along the normal to this line, so unit vector would be like this, n cap. So we are to define this unit vector n cap as cos alpha I cap plus cos beta j cap plus cos gamma k cap, where what are these cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma? These are the direction cosines. Of the vector, of the unit vector n cap, right? So we have defined our unit vector n according to this quantity. So therefore, if I now wanted to calculate the value of cos alpha, how can I obtain its value? If I take the dot product of the vector n with the vector I, it would be cos alpha I cap plus cos beta j cap plus cos gamma k cap. It's dot with I vector means I cap plus 0 j cap plus 0 k cap. So when you take the dot product of this quantity, you will end up with cos of alpha. So you have cos alpha value equal to n vector unit vector dot with I unit vector. In a similar manner, if you take the dot product of this vector n with the vector j, it would be equal to cos beta. If you take the dot product of the vector n with k, it would be cos gamma. So once you have these quantities, now what we wanted to do, we wanted to see the relationship between dx, dy, dz in terms of ds. So that means we wanted to convert the given surface integral into the corresponding line integral. So this represents the surface integral and this would be the double integral. So we are trying to relate these two things. So how can we relate them? So let's see the relation. So relationship between the double integrals and the surface integral, it could be obtained by taking the projection. In fact, the orthogonal projection. Orthogonal means the perpendicular, right? Orthogonal projection. So for that, we have two things, in fact, three things. First is, when you take this surface integral of the vector f dot with n cap ds, this would be equal to the double integral over the region R of the vector f dot n. Now, instead of this ds, you can write dx dy divided by the magnitude of n vector dot k vector, where what is R? R is the orthogonal projection of S on xy plane. So that means whenever you take xy plane, you will have dx dy here, and this would be available when you take the dot product of unit vector n with the unit vector k. Why? Because you can see the reason here. So it is because if you take dx dy and you wanted to represent its projection onto this xy plane, the projection of ds onto xy plane, so it would be ds cos of gamma, because gamma represents the z component. So this was your surface, right? When you took its projection over here, you are in the xy plane. So that means the z component of the surface would map up to here. So it would be ds cos gamma. And what is cos gamma? You have just calculated this equal to n vector dot k vector. So it would be ds into the n vector into k vector magnitude. So this implies your ds is now equal to dx dy divided by the magnitude of unit vector n dot with unit vector k. So this is how you obtain this first projection. Similarly, you will obtain the second formula for projection. So it would be this double integral over s of the quantity vector f vector n ds. This would be equal to the projection over R, the integration over R of the vector f vector n dy dz divided by vector n into vector I, where what is this R? R is, in this case, is the orthogonal projection of the given surface S on yz plane here, right? So if you are on yz plane, so you have dy and dz, and here you will take the dot with I, right? And similarly, for the third case, it would be vector f dot with vector unit vector n ds. This would be equal to vector f dot vector n, and here you would have dz dx divided by the magnitude of vector n dot with vector j here, right? Why? Because y is missing here, so you will take the dot product with j. Now here in this case, the R represents orthogonal projection. It is the orthogonal projection of S on the zx plane, right? So this is how you obtain the integrals. And moreover, we also have one more result. So note that if the vector f that is represented like this, f1 i cap plus f2 j cap plus f3 k cap, in that case, we can calculate our double integral over S of vector n dot with vector s ds. This would be equal to the double integration over S. Now, this thing would now become, in fact, this whole thing that would become f1 dy dz plus f2 dz dx plus f3 dx dy. So this is another result. So I think you understood this concept.